In the USA, the most common fertility treatment given to women is progesterone. In many cases, progesterone is given if a blood test for progesterone is low, or more commonly because of bleeding early in pregnancy. Does this treatment help? In other words, does the chance for having a live birth improve by giving women progesterone? New studies over the last few years have helped us to answer this question. Stay tuned to the end for my Infertility TV bottom line recommendations. Progesterone is a hormone produced by the ovaries in high amounts after ovulation. It is necessary to prepare the uterine lining so that an embryo can implant, and is necessary for maintaining the uterine lining after implantation. Measuring progesterone with a blood test has limited usefulness because the levels jump around a lot and are dramatically different based on the timing of the test. Urine tests for progesterone metabolites have also not been shown to be useful. I talk about both of these concepts in this playlist. Just because we are unable to measure progesterone accurately does not necessarily mean that it is not important. As a result, in the last several years, a number of studies have been performed looking at whether taking extra progesterone after ovulation or in early pregnancy increases the chances for having a live birth. What did these studies find? The first study is known as the PROMISE trial, or Progesterone in Recurrent Miscarriage. The PROMISE trial studied 836 women from 45 hospitals in the United Kingdom and the Netherlands. In order to be included in this study, participants must have had three or more miscarriages, either consecutively or non-consecutively. This was considered a very high-quality study because of its large size and because the patients were split into two treatment groups. Group 1 received real progesterone, and Group 2 received a placebo. Neither the participants or their doctors knew who got what. Statistical analysis found that the tiny difference in the chance for live birth between the two groups was likely due to chance and not because of the treatment given. A second study is known as the PRISM trial, or Progesterone in Spontaneous Miscarriage. The PRISM trial studied 4,153 women from 48 hospitals in the United Kingdom. In this study, participants were enrolled if they had bleeding early in the pregnancy. This is known as a threatened miscarriage. Like the PROMISE trial, participants were split into two groups, with some receiving progesterone and some getting placebo. Again, there was no difference in the live birth rate between the two groups. Researchers tried to determine if there were any subgroups that might have been helped by taking progesterone. The study population was split into three subgroups: women without a history of miscarriage, women with one or two previous miscarriages, and women with three or more previous miscarriages. In this analysis, they found a mild benefit in participants with three or more miscarriages. There was a 14% increase in the chance for live birth. Stated another way, we would need to give progesterone to 8 patients with a history of 3 or more miscarriages and who were bleeding in the current pregnancy in order to get one more live birth. Not dramatic, but something. The most recent study comes from Australia. It is known as the STOP trial. This study ended up being smaller than planned, with only 278 participants. I'll tell you why in a minute. Otherwise, this was just like the PRISM trial, looking at people who were having early pregnancy bleeding. Midway through the study, they did an analysis and found no difference in live births between the progesterone group and the placebo group. Because the outcomes were so similar, the study monitors calculated that continuing the study would not be able to show any benefit to progesterone, so the study was stopped at that point. In the smaller group analysis, there were no benefits found, even if the progesterone level was low or if the progesterones had a number of previous miscarriages. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: we have adequate data now to say with a high degree of certainty that for patients who are having bleeding in early pregnancy, giving them extra progesterone will not improve their chances for having a live birth. A possible exception is for those couples who, in addition to having bleeding, have had three or more previous miscarriages. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.